cut you. They wouldn't believe it at all. And that's why I'm saying one of the most miraculous aspects of the Holy Quran is that the verse, of all course, verses related to religion are very simple and very obvious. You cannot get to understandings of it. But I'm talking about the cosmic verses. Because these were tailored for all times.
Yes.
For all times. A Bedouin at the time of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would find something in it that would suit his intellectual level.
Yes.
But now we see something different in it. And the two understandings do not contradict.
Yeah.
They integrate each other.
Yes.
You see.
But how did the Prophet Muhammad explain that? Or
definitely, he understood it. Definitely.
Yes. No, but how did he explain it to his companions?
He wouldn't explain it in the way we talk about it today. Mm. Because the human intellect at that time could not possibly grasp what we understand today.
Absolutely.
But he definitely understood the details of it because he was in contact with Archangel Jibreel all the time. Yeah. Archangel Jibreel used to come to him every night of the month of Ramadan to read the Quran with him and explain it to him. So he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, knew the details of everything.
Yes.
But of course, he could not spell that out to his companions. Otherwise, their intellect would not bear it.
So he gave a general explanation.
A general explanation, definitely.
Taking you back to the Big Bang now. The verse states that there was the heaven and earth together.
Yes.
Therefore, there was a matter that was present before the Big Bang happened. How do scientists explain that this matter came into being? By chance? And
cannot explain it.
Okay.
They cannot explain it. And this is, again, one of the necessities of Muslims coming forward to explain these things to people who have no faith. Because, you see, they get lost. You see, in the area of creation, if you read any book written by an atheist or an agnostic or secular mentality, you find him really entering a dark tunnel with no light at the end. You see, he is lost. When they speak about the creation of man or the creation of life or the creation of the universe, wallahi, they are virtually lost. Regardless of the ample information they have at hand. Actually, they have more information than we do.
Yeah, and tools. They have very advanced tools also. Yeah.
But yet, they cannot explain it properly. We as Muslims believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created this universe out of nothing. No matter, no energy, nothing. He ordered it to be and it came. He ordered this initial body to explode and it exploded. To change into smoke and change into smoke. From that smoke ordered the earth and the other heavenly bodies to come into being, willingly or unwillingly, they came willingly. So this is the essence of Islam, the essence of belief in Islam. And unless you have that belief, of course you get lost quite easily.
But one of these scholars can have this belief after he is subjected to the studies.
One of the scholars can have...
Can become a believer after subjected to this.
Oh, definitely. Definitely, if you can explain this to, especially somebody in the field.
Yes.
Exactly. If you can explain this. Of course, as I said, in the early tafsir, early exegesis of the Quran, all the commentary came on this verse that the earth and the heavens were one entity.
Only linguistic.
They were joined together. Yeah. You see, what they understood. Mm-hmm. But joined together, earth as earth and heaven as heaven, or firmament as firmament.
Yes.
This is their understanding. But now we understand that they were not necessarily in their present-day shape.
Yes.
They were in an initial form, which would not know anything about it. An initial form with excessive density, with excessive physical chemical characteristics, unknown to us, because this is beyond human knowledge. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered it to explode. It did explode.
Yes.
To change in smoke, created from that smoke whatever he liked to create. And we have this wonderful, systematic, orderly universe.
Is this information present in any other religious book?
I beg pardon?
Is this information present in any other religious book?
No.
Only
if you look at the areas of creation in the Pentateuch, the first five chapters of the Old Testament, which they can consider it to be the Torah. Mm-hmm. You will find a language that is of the level of the knowledge of the time, that's very simple, very primitive. It may have some initial correct source, but when you change the divine language into human language, you actually distort it quite a lot. Mm-hmm. So they talk about creation of the universe, but in a very primitive way that nobody today can
cannot
accept.
Challenge the science of today. Mm-hmm. It not cannot, like the Quran.
It cannot, of course. And that's why, if we have time, I'll say this.
Yes.
A very leading professor in our time, Maurice Bocaille, he used to be a professor at the Sorbonne University in Paris. And he's a medical doctor. Mm. He was called to deal with some of the pharaonic mummies in Egypt. Yes. Started to rot, and he was called through UNESCO to deal with these mummies. And he was, as he was dealing with one of these mummies, he found lots of salt, in his guts.
Yeah.
So he said, this man died drowning. Mm. Everybody around him laughed and said, we all know that. What did you come through with? I said, how did you know it? I only knew it now because I opened his throat and was full of salt.
Yeah.
He said, this is the Pharaoh of Moses. And the Quran tells us that the Pharaoh of Moses died drowning. Yes. And they called the verse, أَلْيَوْمَ نُجِيكَ بِبَدَنِكَ لِذَكُودَ لِمَنْ خَلْفَكَ آيَةً. And he asked, do you really have this in the Quran? They said, yes. Do you have a fresh translation of the meaning of the Quran? They said, yes. They brought him the translation. He sat down in the hotel here in Cairo. Mm-hmm. And through his scientific background, he started to pick up the scientific notions.
Yes.
And he wrote a wonderful book, La Bible, le Coran et la Science. Mm-hmm. The Bible, the Quran, and science. And he showed clearly that all the scientific notions in the Old Testament are wrong as far as the current knowledge of science would go, while all the scientific notions in the Holy Quran are precise
right.
and correct in the light of the present-day knowledge.
Those who fear Allah the most are the scientists and the scholars.
Definitely, yes. Definitely. Mm. And that's why I do believe firmly that the more we explain these cosmic verses to the people of our time in a purely scientific language, without any bias, without any conceit,
yes.
You see, or pride. We present it. This is the truth in the Quran.
Exactly.
And if the Quran is truthful in the area you excel in the area of science, and you find that it's truthful, it has to be truthful in the knowledge of the world of the unseen, which we cannot feel and touch with our own hands.
Yes.
Okay, thank you, Doctor, for your time.
Thanks a lot
to our guests. Inshallah, till next episode. Thank you.